In this lecture, I am going to look at comparative static analysis. So in comparative static analysis, what we do is that we compare old equilibrium with new equilibrium, okay? And what are the changes that have taken place in new equilibrium? We only do that part, okay? So we will be using demand and supply analysis, okay, to do the comparative static analysis. So we will be doing this in three steps, okay? The first part we will be doing is that we will keep the supply curve same, okay, and change the demand curve. We can increase the demand curve and decrease the demand curve. Second case is that we keep the demand to be in the same position, demand curve to be in the same position, and change the supply curve, okay. So here I will have two possibilities, okay, increasing demand and decreasing demand, diverse shift, and this is never shifting demand. Here also I will have two possibilities, increase in supply, diverse shift in supply curve, and diverse shift in supply curve is the decrease in supply, okay. The third possibility that I am going to look at, okay, is where your demand is also changing and supply is also changing and we will be having new equilibrium, okay. So when your demand is changing, okay, there will be two possibilities, increase, decrease, okay. It can either increase or it can decrease. Similarly, supply can increase or decrease, okay. So we will get four possibility. Let's look at it. So demand can increase or decrease. Supply can change in terms of diverse shift or adverse shift, increase or decrease. So we will look at four possibility. Where demand is increasing, supply is increasing. Okay. Second possibility is demand is increasing and supply is decreasing. Third possibility is demand is decreasing and supply is increasing. And fourth possibility, both are decreasing. Okay. So like I talked that there is always three possibility. Okay. So with every one of each one of it, okay, each one of this component, okay, that we have increase, decrease, okay, we will be having three possibility. Okay. So in this case, I will be having three possibilities. Here also, I will be having three possibilities. So of one, we will be having 12 possibilities. Okay. So 12 possibilities I am going to look at when I am changing the demand and supply together. So starting from old equilibrium, okay, what are the changes take place? So when demand and supply increases, okay, there will be three possibilities. Okay. And when there is an increasing demand and decreasing supply, there will be three possibilities. Okay? So we are going to look at all these things. So we are going to look at this 12 possibility and here 2 to 4 possibility. That means we are going to look at 16 possibility. Okay? In this comparative static analysis. Okay. So let's start with this one. Okay. We are keeping the supply condition same. Okay. We will start from the initial equilibrium. So let me draw both graphs. First, I am doing for the case where my supply curve will not change. Let me draw the initial equilibrium. This is supply. Here I am writing price. Here I am writing Q. So Q can be your quantity of output, okay, the product that you are taking, or you can take quantity of labor, okay. So we can consider factor market, okay, competitive factor market as well as product market, okay, because prices in competitive market determined through demand and supply condition, okay. So here I am writing quantity, here I am writing price, okay. So if you are taking quantity of labor, this will be price of labor, okay, that is wage. If you are taking product here, so this will be the price of the product, okay. This is supply. I will denote S1 with my initial supply curve and D1 with my initial demand curve, okay. And this is the origin. So your equilibrium will be Q1, P1, okay. This is my initial equilibrium. Let me draw because I am looking at two possibilities. D1 is my demand curve, S1 is my supply curve, and this is my original equilibrium. Here I am writing output Q, okay. Our quantity, just say quantity, okay. And this is my origin. Here you have Q1, P1, okay. So when demand increases, okay, at new equilibrium, price will be higher and output will be higher. In case of increasing demand, okay, given the supply curve, okay, at new equilibrium, price will be higher, quantity will be higher. Okay, both will be higher. This is comparative static analysis. We are comparing on equilibrium with new equilibrium. Okay? New equilibrium will be on the my new curve. Okay? Money demand curve is same thing. So I will just look at the demand curve because supply curve will give me. This is my point where demand and supply interact. Okay? And giving me equilibrium price and quantity. Okay? Here what is happening? Then demand is decreasing. You can make the arrow this way. Then you can remember. Okay? Demand is decreasing. So when demand decreases, what will happen at new equilibrium? At new equilibrium, quantity will be lower and price will be lower. Okay. So when we do comparative static equilibrium, we only compare on equilibrium with new equilibrium. Okay, and look at what are the changes take place. In case of increasing demand, we see that there is an increase in quantity and price at new equilibrium. In case of decreasing demand, at new equilibrium, we see that there is a decrease in price and quantity. Okay. This is the two possibilities that we have looked at. Okay. So this is the diagram of this part. Okay. Now, second case, this one, demand curve is given. Okay, supply curve changes. So I have two possibility. I will look at that one. So again, never the axis. Here you are writing price. Here you are writing quantity, price, origin, and quantity. So starting from initial equilibrium, D1 is the my initial demand curve, initial supply curve. This is my equilibrium price and quantity Q1. This is my demand curve. This is supply curve, this is my equilibrium quantity and price. So starting from my initial equilibrium, okay? Suppose there is an increase in supply. So when supply curve increased, okay, it will shift right word, okay? So S2, okay? When supply increases at new equilibrium, here I will get the new equilibrium, okay? Equilibrium quantity will be higher, Q2, and price will be lower, P. So here, when I am doing comparative static analysis, when I compare with on equilibrium, the new equilibrium, at new equilibrium, price is lower, equilibrium price is lower, and quantity is higher. Okay. Now, when there is a decrease in supply, okay, never shift in the supply curve, what we see is that equilibrium, at new equilibrium, price will be higher, okay, and equilibrium quantity will be lower. Okay, equilibrium quantity is lower. Okay. So this possibility we have, just draw it. Okay. So second case we have seen. Okay. Now we are changing both demand and supply. Okay. And look at what we will be getting. Okay. The first case, demand also increases, supply also increases. That means both will shift rightward. Okay. So I said that there will be three possibility as associated with any changes. There will be three possibility that we will be studying in economics. Okay. So again, we will start from the initial equilibrium. Okay. And we will increase the we will shift the demand curve rightward and supply curve rightward. Okay. So depending upon the shift, okay, we will get different possibility. So first case we are looking at. You can say 1.1. So I just writing 1.1. Okay. So there will be three possibility. This is one first case, this is second case, this is third case, this is fourth case. Okay. So I'm looking at 1.1. Okay. So increase in demand and increase in supply. Okay. The three possibility I can look together. So I just write one. Okay. Let me draw in one graph. Otherwise it will be tedious. Okay. Let me draw in one graph on the one place on the three possibilities. So again, neighbor the axis, price, quantity. If you are taking neighbor factor market, this is price of neighbor. If you are taking product market, this is price of product. Okay, this is quantity, price, quantity. This is the origin. Okay. Now, starting from initial equilibrium, I said D1 is my initial demand. S1 is my initial supply, D1 is my initial demand, S1 is my initial supply, D1 is my initial demand, S1 is my initial supply. My equilibrium is initial equilibrium is Q1 P1, you have to draw all three graphs same, okay? There are no differences because I don't pay space. So I have drawn, some will be all three graph look different, but it is same, okay? Just consider that to be same. Okay. Now what happened is that both demand and supply increases, okay? So I will increase the demand in all three graph and adjust the supply accordingly. We can do the other way around also, but let me do in one way, okay? So demand cup shift triangle to D2. Supply curve will also shift rightward. Okay. It will shift rightward. So there will be three possibilities that I can have. Okay. Either you can keep the price same. Okay. I shift the supply curve rightward. I keep the price same. Okay. So if I shift here, price will be lower, equilibrium quantity will be high. Here also equilibrium quantity will be high. So I shift, price will be higher. Okay. Equilibrium quantity will be higher. So three possibility that I am going to draw. Okay, quantity will be higher. Okay, price can be higher, lower, or it can be at the same level. At new equilibrium, price can be at the same level. Okay, it can be higher or it can be lower compared to the on equilibrium. On equilibrium is this one. Okay, I will be drawing, don't worry. Okay, but equilibrium quantity will be higher. So in case of increase in demand and increase in supply, the conclusion will be, okay, equilibrium quantity will be higher, okay, price can be higher, okay, lower or can remain the same. Okay, so in this graph I am going to draw where price remain the same. Okay, so I am shifting the supply curve, my demand curve is shift like this, okay, rightward. So I shift the supply curve here, look at this, from this point, okay, S2. So my demand curve shift, supply curve also shift rightward. Okay, so at new equilibrium, at this, okay, equilibrium price remains the same, the on equilibrium price, but equilibrium quantity is higher, Q2. Okay, all equilibrium that we have, initial equilibrium we have, equilibrium price is P1, equilibrium quantity is Q1. At new equilibrium, okay, in this comparative static analysis, price remains the same, but equilibrium quantity is higher. Okay, remember this three dot, okay, then it will be easier to draw graph. Okay, next. Again, I will draw the demand curve, and based on that, I will draw the supply curve. Okay, you can do the other way around and check it. Okay, demand curve will shift rightward in all two cases. Okay, this is D2. Okay, so I told you there will be, let me use it. Three possibility. This possibility I have taken already, where supply curve shift. Okay, in such a manner that you can build a price not changes. Second one is this possibility, third one is this possibility. Okay, let me draw here. Okay. So in this graph, what I am doing is that, okay, I will be drawing from here. Okay, supply curve shift rightward by knitting bit amount. Okay, such that equilibrium quantity increases, but price also increases. Okay, so let me draw from this point. You have to draw parallel graph. Okay. S2. This shift rightward, this shift rightward. Okay. So at new equilibrium, okay, price is higher and output is higher. That is our conclusion. Okay. Both are increasing, demand is increasing, supply is increasing. So output will be higher. Okay. But price can remain the same or it can be higher. Okay. Here P1 equal to P2. You can write P1 equal to P2. Okay. So new equilibrium quantity we have this one. Now, here I will draw my supply curve from this point. So there is a not change in supply, okay, in this case, S2. So it's shift rightward, it's rightward, okay. So at new equilibrium, price is lower and quantity is higher. Okay, so never this graph, this is graph 1, this is graph 2, this is third graph. Okay. So what we see is that when both demand and supply increases, okay, when both changes together, and the case that we are looking at, when demand and supply increases, okay, output is increasing, equilibrium output at new equilibrium, okay, quantity is higher, Q2 is on the right hand side, okay, towards the right hand side of your own equilibrium, okay, but equilibrium price can remain the same, okay, or it can increase from P1 to P2, or it can decrease from P1 to P2. Okay, see, it is decreasing here, it is increasing here, it remains the same. Okay, so this is the conclusion when demand increases and supply increases. Okay. Second case. Okay. Let me take photo. So second case is demand is increasing and supply is decreasing. Okay. So three possibilities I have to look at. Again, name the axis first. Put the origin. D1 is my initial demand, S1 is my initial supply. Start with initial equilibrium, that will become on equilibrium when there is a changes. P1, Q1. D1 is my initial demand curve, S1 is my initial market supply curve. Okay. P1, Q1. Demand supply S1, D1, Q1, P1. Okay. Now. Demand increases, okay, and supply decreases. Demand curve been shift rightward, supply curve been shift leftward. Okay, so let me shift the demand curve. Let me use the name. Demand curve shift rightward. Okay, to no. Supply curve been shift leftward. Okay, how much will be the shift? Okay, determine. Okay, whether equilibrium quantity is decreasing. Remains the same or it is increasing. Okay. So let me draw 3 points. Okay. Then it will be easier to draw the graph. So let me draw 9 like this. Okay. If I shift my supply curve here, equilibrium quantity remains the same. If I draw like this, okay. But at new equilibrium price will be higher. So what point will be this one? Okay. Second point I can draw here. Okay. So here, if I draw my supply curve, equilibrium quantity will be higher and price will be higher. Okay. So in the first case, quantity is not changing, but price is higher. Okay. Second case, quantity is higher, price is also higher. Third case, quantity is lower when I draw the supply curve, when the shift is quite large. Okay. Quantity is low, but price is higher. So in this case, okay, what we see is that price will be higher. Okay. At new equilibrium, quantity can remain the same or it can increase or decrease depending upon the shift in your supply curve. Okay. Similarly, you can look through shifting demand curve, keeping the, you change the supply curve, shift the supply curve, never, and depending upon how much you are shifting your demand curve, okay, you will be knowing that three possibilities will exist. Okay. So, let me draw 3 points here also, then it will be faster to do it. Okay. Let me see the report. Okay. So here, in first case, what I am doing is that I am keeping the equilibrium, okay, quantity, okay, the new equilibrium quantity to be the same as on equilibrium quantity. Okay. So I am shifting parallel to this point from this point. Okay. S2. So your demand curve is shift rightward. Supply curve is shift leftward. Okay. So at new equilibrium. Price is P2 and new equilibrium quantity remains the same, unlike on equilibrium quantity. Okay. here, I am shifting here to this point, okay? You can shift to this point, it up to you, okay? So, let me shift here. Draw it parallel, okay? So, demand curve shift rightward, supply curve shift leftward. At new equilibrium, okay? Quantity is higher and price is higher. Your conclusion will be that, okay, price will be higher. Magnitude does not matter right now, okay? That we will be doing later on. Okay, you need to understand only that part, okay, that price will be higher, okay? You can, at new equilibrium, quantity can be same, it can be higher or it can be lower, okay? Here, I am drawing from this side, at this point, shift in supply is quite large, okay? So, at new equilibrium, D2S2, okay, what I see is that equilibrium quantity is Q2 and price is higher P2, okay? So when demand increases or supply decreases, okay, at new equilibrium in this comparative static analysis, price will be higher. Equilibrium quantity at new equilibrium quantity can remain the same. It can be higher or it can be lower. Okay. This is the second case. And you can draw the arrow. This part, okay. This is increased, this is decreased, okay. That part is increased. Okay. Now we will look at third case. So we have looked at 3, 6 possibilities, 7, 8, 9, 10 possibilities, okay. That means I have to draw two more graph, 3 possibilities we will look at, then we finish. Demand is decreasing and supply is increasing. Let me draw three graph. You write price here, quantity here, origin here, price, quantity, origin, price. Initial demand can be D1, supply can be S1, D1, S1. So, initial equilibrium is Q1, P1, okay, and this will become my own equilibrium when there is a changes, okay. So, we compare new equilibrium with own equilibrium, Q1, P1, okay. Now, demand decreases, okay. So, let me decrease the demand, okay. I will adjust through supply. Demand decreases to D2, this is D1. Supply increases, okay. So when supply increases, okay, there can be three possibility, okay. Supply curve increases, it can shift rightward, okay. So if it shift rightward, okay, if it passes through here, okay, what will happen? Price will be lower, quantity will be lower. At new equilibrium, price will be lower, and equilibrium quantity will be here. If it passes from this point, okay, what will happen? Equilibrium quantity remains the same, but price will be lower. If it passes through this point, what will happen? Okay, equilibrium quantity will be higher, but price will be lower. Okay, so in this case also, we see that. Okay, in this case, we see that price will be lower in all the three cases. Okay, equilibrium quantity can remain the same, or it can be lower or higher. Okay. So in first case, I am looking at the possibility where price remain the same. Quantity remain the same. Equilibrium quantity, new equilibrium quantity remain the same, and price is lower. Okay, because in all the three possibilities that we are going to look at, price will be lower. So demand curve shift decreases, so it shift leftward. Supply increases, it will shift rightward. Okay. This is new supply curve. This is new demand curve, so this is equilibrium, price is P2. So at new equilibrium, okay, equilibrium price is lower, P2, but quantity remains the same, okay. So here also you draw three dot, okay. One dot is this one, second, third, let me draw the dot, then it will be easy. Okay. Now, in this case, I am shifting supply curve just a little bit, okay. has to. So here we will see that equilibrium price will be lower. I have shown you. We are getting 3% where equilibrium price is lower. Okay. Here, then at new equilibrium quantity is also lower. Q2. Okay. Let me write. Q2. This is Q1. This part. Okay. Equilibrium quantity is lower and price is lower. Okay. When shift in demand is more than shift in supply, and there is very little shift in supply, we see that. Okay, equilibrium quantity is lower, price will be lower. Okay, for sure. Third case, when shift in supply is quite large, okay, compared to demand, okay, you can say that. What you see that equilibrium quantity is high, price will be lower at new equilibrium. So here, what conclusion we have? Okay, price for sure will be lower at new equilibrium. Okay, quantity can remain the same at on equilibrium, or it can be higher. Okay, it can increase from Q1 to Q2, or it can be lower. Okay. Now, 13 possibility we have seen last month. This is third case. Okay, decreasing demand and supply increases. Okay, this is third possibility. Okay, last month. Demand decreases and supply decreases. Okay. Again, growth is graph. We take price here, origin here, Q here, price, origin, Q, price, origin, Q. Okay. This is demand curve, this is supply. Initial demand supply curve, okay, this is equilibrium P1, Q1. B1 is my initial demand, S1 is my initial supply, equilibrium, we are both interact. Equilibrium, initial equilibrium price is P1, quantity is Q1. This is demand B1, this is supply S1. Initial equilibrium price is P1, Q1. Both decreases, okay, let me decrease the demand curve. So I decrease the demand curve. D2. And supply also decreases. Okay, supply curve also decreases. Okay, it's a net. Okay. So I can have three possibility. Okay. So one possibility is that it's shift here. Okay. Equilibrium price remain the same, quantity form. Okay. Second, I shift here. Okay. Equilibrium price can be higher at new equilibrium, quantity being form. Why can shift here? So I have to shift network. Equilibrium price will be lower, but quantity will be lower compared to the initial equilibrium. So quantity will be lower. Okay, that we know for sure that at new equilibrium, my quantity will be lower compared to my on equilibrium. Okay, because supply curve is shifting network. Okay, so I have to draw the supply curve network this one. Okay, there will be three possibilities. Let me draw here also 3 points. So here I am shifting my supply curve left. Okay, demand shift this way. Demand decreases, supply also decreases. Supply also shift left. Okay. So at new equilibrium, I am keeping the price same P1, which is equal to P2. Okay. And equilibrium quantity will be lower. Okay. So in three cases, equilibrium quantity will be lower. How much lower? Magnitude not matter. This is my S2. Okay. So at new equilibrium, okay, price remains the same at on price, no on equilibrium price, and equilibrium quantity is lower. Okay, Q. Here I am drawing from this point. Okay. Draw it by NN, okay. Here see gap is going, just you have to draw properly, okay. So here I am having new equilibrium where price is lower. At new equilibrium price is lower, quantity will be lower. Okay, that is the conclusion. Third one, shift is quite large in the supply curve. Okay, quantity will be lower, price is higher. What we see is that, okay, when demand decreases and supply decreases, both decreases together, what conclusion we have? At new equilibrium, okay, quantity will be lower for sure. okay, equilibrium quantity win-win over. Okay, price can remain the same. Okay, it can be lower or it can be higher. Equilibrium price can be higher, it can be lower, or it can remain the same depending upon shift in demand and supply condition. Okay, I hope this video is clear. Okay, in this way we do comparative static analysis. So these are the 16 possibility that you will be facing when you are doing comparative static analysis. Okay, I hope this video will be helpful. Okay, thank you for watching.